Hey guys, Kate Kennedy here with my first holiday card of the season. I'm not doing like a series or anything, but I just got some new goodies and I wanted to share this card. So this is the first one I made, not in a video. And then I liked it so much, I was like, well, I'm going to do a video and show everybody how to make it. So this is the supplies that I used. I used these watercolors, some Mama Elephant dyes, this older paper pad from Basic Gray, paintbrush, and two stamp sets from the new Hero Arts Christmas release. One is called Bird and Branch, and one is called Christmas Crystals. So I'm starting off with some Tim Holtz watercolor paper, and I'm just stamping and embossing the different ornaments that I want to use. I'm also using Nina Solar White 110-pound cardstock for the card base. So the first thing I do is apply like a wash of clean water, and then I start with the watercolors. These watercolors are super awesome. I have a link below to them. You can get them on Amazon and I think the Mama Elephant website. And there's a gold one. So this is the gold one. I don't end up using it on this card because the tone of it is not what I was looking for, but it is really pretty. And then I like this green also. So since the tone doesn't really work that well for me, I decide to pull out this brown color. And again, you can see there, I just use a big watercolor brush to put down a wash of clean water, and it helps get the color moving. And what I really like about these watercolors is that they're really easy to layer. And you'll see throughout this process, I will even dry it and come back and add more color. So I'm just drying it with my heat gun really quickly. And you want to be careful doing this because you did emboss, so you don't want to make that embossing get too soft, because then if you touch it, it will make a mess. So you have to be a little bit careful with that. So here you can see I'm just kind of building the color with those watercolors, and I wanted to make the darker edges a little bit darker. And I'm just kind of arranging these ornaments on that Nina Solar White paper. And then I'm going to take the branch from this Bird and Branch set and stamp and emboss that in gold and kind of have the ornaments sort of hanging off of it. The top green one, I'm going to actually cut the little thingy off so it's not hanging because it doesn't have any string. I was just testing my embossing power tool there because it didn't seem to be working very well. That's what I was doing, rubbing it on my hand like that. So here I'm just stamping the branch. I'm kind of going to make it go off the paper a little bit. And then I'm just using some gold detail embossing powder, cleaning it up with a dry brush. And there I have kind of arranged them all. And I'm using some foam tape to put the ornaments down with. And then I'm going to take the little string from the Christmas crystal set. And I believe I use Stays On ink. I was going to use MFT hybrid ink, but for some reason I decided to use Stays On. I don't know why. So I'm just kind of seeing how many dots I need. And then I'm going to stamp some for that bigger brown colored ornament also. This would be an easy card to mass produce because you could do like all the ornaments at one time. And they're super easy to fussy cut because they're just basic shapes. And now I'm taking the Mary, the Ampersand, and the Bright from this stamp set also, and stamping those on the bottom. And I just think they'd be easy to make a bunch of them. And you don't have to use dimensional adhesive if you want to keep it flat, like for mailing purposes. So I'm just adding the sentiment, and then I think I'm going to adhere it to the base, which is that kind of birch looking paper that I die cut with the Mama Elephant petite frames or femme frames, something like that. Now I'm just scoring my card base. It's just a standard A2 size card, 5.5 by 4.25. I'm going to adhere that front panel down. And then I'm going to take some Pretty Pink Posh sequins. And I love that she makes mixes of her sequins, so that way you don't have to buy like each individual color. So this one has red and green and gold in it, and I'll have a link below to that from that too. I got it from Simon Says Stamp. because I don't need like a whole thing of green, a whole thing of red, and a whole thing of gold. And I love flat sequins, and she makes the mixes in either cupped or flat, which is awesome. I think they're the best sequins, personally. So this is a tip I got from Jennifer McGuire, which is to put your Ranger Multi Matte Medium down just on your craft mat, and then just use the little tool here, which I've been using that tool, but I hadn't used the Ranger Matte Medium before. So that is going to finish up the card, and oh no, it's not. I'm sorry. I'm going to add some of this Wink of Stella, and since I use watercolor, a little bit does come off on the brush, but I'm just wiping it off to the side there to make sure none of the colors carry over, and it cleans up perfectly. So just adding a little bit of shimmery detail to the ornaments, and that is it. So here is a close-up of this card. Thanks guys so much for watching, and I'll see you real soon. Bye!